Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Tally, last name Cigarelli, if you were wondering how to pronounce that. And I'm back again with another video for you all. Thank you so far for all the support I've been getting. And you know, even people who disapprove, you know, thank you too, because I appreciate all publicity and I appreciate all, you know, whatever anybody has to say, you know, it's all good. It's all good to me. You know, no beef. It's all, you know, it's what's up. You know, but you know, for the people who do support me, there's more on the way, more to come. There's more to be developed in all of this. So just stay with me, keep following me, you know, still, you know, be by my side. So today I feel like this video is so important, okay? I feel like all my videos are so important, but this one is a big one, okay? Because this is so common to a lot of women my age, maybe a little younger than me and even older than me. And I just remember what it is that I remember that, you know, when I was younger, maybe around like since I could remember, us girls, we talk about getting married when we're like 5 years old, right? And usually that age that everybody talks about is 30, right? I wanna be married by 30. And now I'm 26 years old and I'm not married. You know, I'm actually single, so I'm not even in a relationship. So I'm not that close to being married either. So now is the time for me to revisit those things and really think about those things, because not only am I single and unmarried, there's a lot of women around me, you know, my age, maybe a little younger, maybe a little older, who are single and unmarried. And also now there's women around me who are married, and there's women who are engaged to get married. So where does us unmarried women in our 20s fit in all of that? You know what? We're here. Don't ask where we fit in, because we're just here. And you know, we're here, we're doing our thing. And what I want to let every woman out there know, from 20 to 29, who probably has a similar timeline, I want to be married by 30. I want to let you know that it is not important to be married by 30. Listen, let's stop playing with the institution of marriages. Like the institution of marriage, let's stop playing with it, okay? We've seen what marriage could be like, you know, the stress about it. And I don't want to make this like anything to bash marriage, because marriage could be so beautiful. And to those who are experiencing marriage, you know, I believe marriage is what you make it. You know, it's what you make it. Of course, there's hard times and everything, but marriage can be so beautiful. And I truly believe that. You understand? And there's downsides to everything in life, but I believe everything you work hard on and you actually invest time and effort and love into, it can be very beautiful. But for those of us who are still single and we had that timeline that said, I had to be married by 30, let me tell you, we don't have to have that timeline anymore. Let it go, okay? Let it go. Because these timelines that we be having, these things could get us in trouble. As I was saying, stop playing with the institution of marriage, okay? We've seen how marriages could be a disaster, to say it bluntly. And we've seen, a lot of us has never seen how marriage could be good. You know, some of us have. And if you have seen that, that's a blessing for you. But a lot of us, we've seen the disaster part of it. And with that being said, once again, as I said, we need to stop playing with the institution. And what I mean is, marriage is not some date we put on our timeline and say, this is the date I need to be married by. I need to be in a relationship at this time, and he needs to propose to me this time. You know, hold up. Before we go there, you feel me? I'm not for being in a relationship with a long period of time with someone who is not marrying you. That is terrible. Okay, I don't want to say terrible, but that is a cause for concern. Let's put that right there, pin in that. I might do a video about that later on, but this is not what it's about today. But what I'm saying today, marriage is not something to play with. It's not something on your timeline. It's not something that you need to have to show off to your friends, because that's what a lot of people want to do. They want to show off to their friends like, oh, look, somebody want me. Somebody put a ring on it. I didn't want to show this hand because I have a nail missing, but you get the point. No, but marriage is not that. Marriage is not something that you want so you can feel validated. You could feel like you're some power couple, or you can post pictures on Instagram saying, oh, look at this. This is my fiance. Oh, relationship goals. If that's the reason why you want marriage, you are in for a rude awakening. Marriage is a covenant between two people before God to stay with this person and to love, honor, and respect this person in sickness and in health, for rich or for poor, in good times and bad times. And a lot of people don't understand how deep that goes. We obviously don't understand how deep that goes because, like I always mention, look at the rate of divorce. And after the rate of divorce, look at how many people stay together, but they're unhappy. So we don't understand how deep these things go. And until we have an understanding on how deep these things go, we need to put those fantasies on pause. We have an opportunity this generation only, because this is the first generation that has the opportunity that we have, that access to information, to resources, to really help us and to groom us. Okay, I'm not saying everything's going to be squared away, worked out before you get married, because marriage is just one of those things, like, you really learn, you know, your stride, really how to do things when you get into it. So there's going to be things so that it just hits you by surprise. But we do have some kind of information, you know, and we do have other people we could look up to ask for advice that can give us some pointers on how to really maybe bypass some mistakes that have been done in the past. And this is what we need to look to. In this time where you are not married, or you're just in a relationship, or you're single, we need to be looking for resources to help us to be better single people, better inter-relationship people, so we could be better married people. Also, we need to be working on ourselves. We need to be working on ourselves, our brand, our business, our brain. These are the things that we have an opportunity to work on before we get married. Because the advice I receive about marriage that I can share with you guys is the better you get to know yourself and who you are before you get married, is the better your marriage is going to be. Because it's good when both parties involved know who they are, know their purpose in life, know who they're called to be. And I believe, especially as a woman of faith, I believe this is the things that God is trying to instill in us. Now, he saw it fit. Shout out to those people who got married early. I'm not mad at you. And please don't take this no kind of way. For the people who got married early when they were young, shout out to y'all. God saw it fit that marriage would be a part of your process, would be a part of your grooming process and a part of your purpose in him. Marriage is an institution. It fit. It wasn't the purpose for you. So don't be mad at that. Embrace that and rock with it. And God bless you. But for the rest of us who needed that extra time to work and build on ourselves, don't hate on that time either. Let's enjoy that time. Let's not take it for granted. Let's do what the most that we can do to better ourselves internally, to work on those personal traumas, those childhood traumas, those things that we need to heal from the inside out. Those things that affected us in a way, and if we don't address them, these things could be detrimental to our marriages. So this is what I'm saying is use this time wisely. This is the perfect time to work on yourself, to better yourself, you know, and to love yourself, to show yourself self-love, to go on a self-love journey. You know, see this time as see this time as an opportunity, even as a privilege for yourself. Don't buy into the mentalities of this world or even the mentalities of back then, like these that married by 30. That's like a 1950s, 1920s mentality where, you know, where they said like maybe like women, when they reach a certain age, they were, you know, they were less valuable. Why are we buying into those kind of mentalities? Women were less valuable older back then is because women couldn't work, women couldn't hold businesses, women had no rights, women couldn't vote, women couldn't do nothing back then. So the only thing a woman was good for back then, you guessed it, is her looks. That's it. So guess what? It was beneficial to a woman and her father and mother, you know what I'm saying, who are getting money because, you know, you give a woman's hand in marriage, you get a dowry. So her mother and father get a dowry. So that's money paid to the family, you know, so that helps your family out, you know. So back then, a woman's ass, the woman was an asset, and you know, and she was more property, and having her and giving her hand in marriage, it was advantageous for your whole family. So of course, if you're considered property, an item, an asset, of course the best condition, the, you know, that's why women were getting married at 13, 14, 15, the younger the better. Okay, that was the mentality of back then when women couldn't have anything going for themselves. But nowadays, women are business women. Women are CEOs. Women are leaders. Women are pastors. Women are, you know what I'm saying? Women are managers. Women are millionaires. You feel me? So do not get trapped in that old mindset. Women are more valuable than their looks. I'm not saying looks don't count for nothing, because we're women, looks will always count for something. We're people in general, they will always count for something. But I'm saying your value today is not only in your looks. You have more value to you. You have some internal value. You have some from some an asset, and you have assets that are not only in your physical features. So remember that these are the things that if God saw fit for you to be, you know, in your 20s, in your late 20s, or even in your early 30s, late 30s, and you feel like you're unmarried, if God saw that fit for you, that's what God wants you to build up. You know, he's giving you the opportunity. He's keeping you in what we call protective custody. Protective custody means it's not your time yet. It's not your season yet to be married. So don't force anything. You never want to force anything. Once you force something, that comes because you feel some kind of desperation in you. And desperation is a weak emotion. Operating out of depression too, but desperation, that's a weak emotion that you never want to fall victim to, because it's going to cause you to choose something, to choose someone that either wasn't meant for you now or was never meant for you to begin with. And you never want to look back and say like, wow, I could have been better off if I would have did it this way and this way. You know, you never want to do that. So if you have the opportunity not to do that, then please embrace this time. Embrace this time. Thank God for this time and trust that he will give you the desires of your heart in due time, because God knows the perfect time. He knows when you're ready for a husband to find you. He knows when that time is. So why can't you just trust in him like you do for everything else? Work on yourself. Be like Ruth. You feel me? She was gathering wheat or barley. You feel me? I don't know what it was in the field. You feel me? She was working. She was about her business. She was working. And boom, that man noticed her right in the field. You feel me? So we need to have that roof mindset. Like, you know what? I'm going to be about my business. And boom, that man going to pop up on you in the season that you're ready to be seen. So never be desperate for a man or a husband. Never, you know, look at your friends getting married or getting engaged and have that make you feel like you need to rush to do anything, because I guarantee you, it's not, you're not operating from the right place if that's the case. Okay, enjoy your season of singleness. If you're single, enjoy your season of being in a relationship. And you know, you need to be checking for them red and yellow flags and verifying everything and evaluating everything to see if this is something that you can do in the long run, you know, and enjoy your season of marriage if you are married, you know, and don't keep looking over the other side of things, because the grass always looks greener on the other side. What we need to do is just water your own grass. So whatever season you happen to be in, water your own grass, which means invest in your relationship or invest in your singleness. Invest in that season you are in. Apply effort and time to whatever season that is, and before you know it, your season is gonna be looking great to you, and other people gonna be looking at your season. It's gonna look great to them too. And now, if I'm, you know, a partner, a potential partner, and my season looking real green on this side, that's gonna be, my partner's gonna be more attracted to me. So if you're watering your grass in your singleness season, you making yourself look very good and available. You're not looking like you just downtrodden and desperate and you need somebody to come save you, but you're looking all vibrant and you're looking at life from a perspective of prosperity and abundance. If you're looking good, you handling your business, you working in your purpose in life, you working in your calling, you know, if you're doing all that, you look more attractive to a partner than someone who needs somebody to save them. So just think about that right there. Don't allow nothing in this world to rush you. Appreciate what you have. Appreciate what season you in. And just be you. And know that in the right time, God is going to send somebody for you. Please. No, but that's what my message to you guys is today. Thank you. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comments. I know a lot of people don't get this far, but I really want to know what you guys think about this, and you know, and just tell me what your take is on this, because I know that I said to myself I wanted to be married by 30, but now that I'm 26, I have no problem readjusting that. I have no problem readjusting that, because it's better to marry later than I expected than to marry wrong. You understand that? And some people say it's better to marry late than marry wrong. But what is late? You know what I'm saying? Late is later than your timeline. Don't call it late because it's later than you expected. That's why I say it's later than you expected, but it's not late. Okay, you get married in the season you're supposed to get married to. You get married in the season. You find the partner in the season that is destined for you. As long as you're handling your business, you're being social, you're out there, you're taking care of yourself, you're doing what you need to do for you, your time, your season will come. And you have to trust in that. As a woman of faith, if you're watching me as a woman of faith, that's what we trust in. But hey, if you're not a woman of faith, then you know about the universe. You know what I'm saying? The karma, everything that goes around. I don't know too much about that. But you know the universe, the karma that goes around, comes around. You already know. So if you're putting good, positive energy, positive vibes out there, you know how y'all say it, then that's gonna come back to you. All right, so trust in that, trust in this. Let me know what you think. Love you guys.